Hello everyone, welcome back to the Angular Live project. In this video, we will understand about the JWT authentication. We will see how JWT authentication works and how it is helpful into the applications and how it provides the authentication for the users. So before creating a login API in our ASP.NET Core API, we will understand about the JWT authentication. So let's understand what is the JWT. So JWT is basically known as JSON Web Token, and as per the definition of the JWT, it's a open standard JWT, and it is used to provide the secure way to communicate the data between two parties or as a JSON object. Two parties means like we want to pass the data between the like a server and the client, then it pass the data using the JSON format, and this information can be verified and trusted because it is digitally signed, and JWT can be signed using a secret. Basically it is written using an algorithm called HMAC or a public private key using the RSA or ECDSA. So that we will see in a bit, like how it is secure while transmitting the data between two parties. So when we are going to design any JSON application, so the WAV token which it generate, the basically structure of that token, it consists or it is basically divided into three part, and every part is differentiate using the dot keyword. So it contains three parts. One is the header, next is the payload, and third is the signature. So header, basically it's a JSON format which is encoded in base 64, and payload is also a JSON format which is also encoded into the base 64. And next is the signature. It is important, and if we make any changes into the signature, like based on that it verify the token is correct or not. So this signature is basically created and signed based on the header and the claims which is encoded in base 64. Claims is nothing but the payload, and therefore, like if we are going to create a JWT token, that we will see in the coming video when we will design the login API. So it look like to this one, like there are three like separate format, and all are separated using the dot keyword here. So in this manner we generate the JSON web token that it is useful while login or authentication or authenticating the pages. If you want to know more about the JSON authentication, you can go to this link, and from here you can learn more about the JSON. So before that, let's understand how this JWT authentication works. So in this picture you can see, like we have the browser, or we can say the client app, and the server where it check for the JWT authentication. So as per in this picture, suppose user log into an application and they fill their username and password or any other security credential, and once user give their credential, the browser or the client app, so basically this client app send a post request with the user credential. So this is the post request with using the credential which are sent over the HTTP connection. So this is the HTTP connection it sent, and then the user credential are checked against the login database. So it check the login credential, and those login credential if valid, then the server create and encrypt and access JWT which is stored into the body of the response. And after storing into the body of the response, when the user request a page, like any other user go to the any other page, the browser or client app store the access JWT inside the authorization section of the request. So it do that one, and then server verify the JWT signature that we have seen. So the server verify the JWT signature and extract the user information from JWT payload. So that it do, and after that the request page or the resource is sent to the client, as we are seeing here. So in this manner, this JWT authentication basically works into the applications. So like what we have seen, like suppose any user enter the credential, then it create a post request and then check with the database like it is working properly, like in the database credential is matching. Then after that it create a one token, that is JWT token, and into the like it store that token into the response headers. And when user is try to access any page, then it verify that particular request using the JWT payload, and according to that it responds the page to us. So that is about the JWT process flow, like how it works into the application. And if you want to learn more about it, so as I explained, like you can go to this URL jwt.io, and from here you can see the introduction of this one, and briefly they have explained it. And if you want to see the token how it works, so you can click on the debugger, and here you can see like we have the three separate like headers here. One is this, and then divided by dot, then second is this, and then divided by dot here as well, and according to that it is giving the response. So you can learn more about the JWT authentication. So that's it for this video. Thank you.